people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go.
What's up, everybody, and welcome to Life Groups. This morning was our Speed the Light service, so I want to say a big thank you for all that participated with us to raise money for missions. Speed the Light is the youth department's way to give so that missionaries have the equipment that they need to communicate the message of the gospel and the transportation that they need to get it where it needs to go. But tonight we want to look at what it means for us and in our own lives to be the light. See, in Matthew chapter 5, Jesus is teaching and telling us that no one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket, but that they take the lamp and set it out to where the light can fill the whole house and that everyone can see. And he says, in the same way, let your light shine before all men so that people will see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. See, we know that when Jesus came into the world, that John says that he was the light. The light came and shone in the darkness. And as Jesus is in us, we are his light into this world. He wants to use you to spread his light, the message of his love, the message of the gospel to the world, so that they wouldn't live in darkness of sin any longer. So in your workplace, in your families, in your community, he wants you to be the light. He wants you to let your light shine before all men, so that people will see what you do and it will draw them to the one that loves them. So how can we be the light? How can we spread our light? But how can we first make sure that the light is truly in us? Because see, in 1 John says that God is the light. But then he says that if we claim to have fellowship with the light but are really just living in darkness, then we're lying to ourselves and to others. That we need to make sure that we don't just say, hey, we know Jesus, but then our lives don't match that, or that we don't know him. We need to make sure that he is in us, that we are bearers of his light. And then we take the light, speed the light, get the light into these places, in these dark places of our world, where people need to see how much God really loves them. So what can we do? And as we start the conversation tonight, what can we do to bring the light of Jesus into our world? And I want to challenge us in the story that challenges me of a 20th century missionary, A.W. Milne, who went to the New Hebrides Islands knowing that he would very well probably be martyred. Now, Milne did die there, but he didn't die from being a martyr. He actually died of old age, because as the light shined through him into the villagers and the people of the New Hebrides Islands, the revival broke out, and A.W. Milne spent the rest of his life ministering there in the New Hebrides Islands. And as he died there and they buried him, they wrote on his tombstone this epitaph, that when he came, there was no light, but when he left, there was no darkness. What can we do for that to be said of us? Thank you for joining us tonight. And again, continue this conversation of how you can be the light and how we can bring the light of Jesus Christ and the message of the gospel into our world. Thank you so much.
Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright.